If you could choose any superpower, what would you pick? It's a question that gets asked at get-togethers all of the time, and you will always have at least one person who chooses the superpower that keeps them hidden away – invisibility. Even the statistics agree. Back in 2015, Forbes collected data from 7,065 business leaders from around the world, with each being asked the superpower question. Between 24 and 29% chose invisibility over being able to fly in that quiz, depending on their level of management. What does any of this have to do with Putin's devastating special military operation in Ukraine? The average human may never be able to fly, but thanks to the genius of Ukraine's military minds, they can now turn invisible. That's right, Ukraine has created an invisibility cloak that feels like it was pulled straight out of the Harry Potter books, and it's making Ukraine's soldiers unstoppable. So how does the cloak work? And just how invisible does it make a soldier who's wearing it? We answer all those questions and more in this video, starting with the obvious question first of all, just what is this special cloak? We got our first glimpse into Ukraine's new cloak in October 2023. That's when multiple outlets, including The Independent, started reporting its existence. According to that newspaper, the special cloak had been designed in Ukraine to hide soldiers away from thermal imaging cameras that Russia installs in its tanks, planes, and drones. The idea was simple. A soldier wears the cloak, which blocks all of the thermal energy their body produces. With that energy blocked, Russia's thermal imagers can't spot the soldier in the field, allowing them to go about their missions without worrying that Russian mechanized units and drones will spot them. If you've ever seen the movie Predator, the footage demonstrating the cloak's abilities will show you precisely what it does. In the movie, the titular Predator tracks its prey by identifying body heat. Thermal imaging cameras do precisely the same thing, showing humans as blobs of red and yellow on the screen. When a Ukrainian soldier wears his new invisibility cloak, the telltale heat signature disappears, leaving behind a murky mixture of blacks and grays that blend in perfectly with the cooler background images a thermal imaging camera captures. Ukraine's Deputy Prime Minister for Innovation, Education, Science and Technology, and Minister for Digital Transformation, Mykhailo Fedorov, was quick to hail the novel invention when it first appeared toward the end of 2023. "Have you ever read about invisibility cloaks in fairy tales?" he asked in a statement. Well, Ukrainians made it. The cloak blocks heat radiation and makes defenders invisible to Russian thermal cameras. It will help our soldiers work effectively during the night. As Fedorov says, the cloak feels like it was pulled out of the pages of a fairy tale. But it's real, and it's being used by Ukrainian soldiers in their fight against Russia. In a separate statement published on the Ukrainian World Congress website, Fedorov goes into even more detail about the cloak. He points out that the cloak defends Ukraine's soldiers from infantry and drones that may be carrying thermal imaging cameras, with a particular focus on special operations groups. Fedorov notes that the cloaks are especially useful against enemy snipers or special operations forces groups that perform combat tasks, hailing the cloak as just one of the developments that will help save the lives of our soldiers at the front. He's not wrong. We get an even better idea of how the cloak works thanks to a video Fedorov shared on X. The footage shows a pair of soldiers standing side by side as they're filmed using a thermal imaging camera. Both give off a telltale red and yellow heat signature that Putin's drones and mechanized units would use to pinpoint their positions in the field. It's only after closely inspecting the video that you realize there aren't two soldiers at all. There are three. One soldier standing to the left of his two comrades has been hiding in plain sight the entire time. The only slight hint that he's even there comes from a small heat signature generated by his face. All the soldier has to do is turn around, lie down, or cover his face, and the thermal imaging camera wouldn't pick him up at all. So we come to more questions. How does Ukraine's invisibility cloak work, and where does it come from? Fedorov answers the second question for us. He attributes the design and development of the cloak to Brave One, which is a Ukrainian government initiative created to encourage the country's scientific minds to innovate on the battlefield. That initiative isn't limited to Ukraine. The country's government has created a digital platform through which it welcomes international partners, including military minds from the likes of the United States, to collaborate with them on technological ideas that could help Ukraine in its defense against Putin's invading forces. And anybody can join. You only need to register to the Brave One online portal to submit your idea to the system. The Brave One team then examines the idea, delivering feedback and providing assistance to fund and ensure its development if Ukraine identifies the project as something that might help on the battlefield. It's through Brave One that we meet one of the cloak's co-creators, Maxim Boryak. He, along with Fedorov, provides more details about how the cloak works. The clever invention weighs around 5.5 pounds, making it lightweight enough to wear on the battlefield without discomfort and portable enough to fold up and transport in a rucksack when it's not in use. It's also an all-weather cloak. The wearer is protected from the cold, snow, and rain when conditions get rough. And during summer, when temperatures in Ukraine can climb up to and above 71.6 degrees Fahrenheit, the cloak ensures the wearer doesn't burn up thanks to intelligently placed ventilation throughout. but it's the cloak's material that's the highlight. Though Boryak doesn't share the precise material used, likely to ensure that Russia doesn't copy his idea, we know that it's a combination of insulator and reflector. The outer material reflects any incoming heat away from the cloak, keeping it cool and ensuring the garment doesn't show up on thermal imaging cameras. Internally, the cloak insulates the wearer, keeping their body heat inside from where it slowly escapes via a series of small ventilation slits. That heat escape is so controlled that it barely shows up on thermal images at all, rendering the wearer practically invisible. Cleverly, the designers have also designed the outer material to offer standard camouflaging effects that gives the cloak utility in the daytime. The Ukrainian soldier need only lie down, and they become difficult to distinguish in forested and leafy areas. The cloak also covers almost the entire body, as it's fitted with a hood that goes over the soldier's head. Only a scrap of body heat escapes via the face, and that's only if the soldier's face is uncovered. Boryak says that Brave One has already developed masks and face coverings that offer similar thermal invisibility properties that would render a cloak wearer practically invisible to thermal sensors. It's an ingenious idea, and it's a concept that brings us to another question. How will this new invisibility cloak help Ukraine in its fight against Russia? We've already touched on the main benefit in terms of the cloak's ability to hide Ukrainian soldiers away from the thermal imaging cameras Russia uses on the battlefield. To understand why that's so important, we need to dig into how the thermal cameras work and why they're so dangerous to Ukraine's troops. It all comes down to infrared energy. Practically every object on Earth emits at least a little infrared energy, with that emittance being the object's heat signature. Thermal imaging cameras pick up on this heat signature, with hotter signatures being shown on the camera via red and yellow coloring, while cooler signatures are a bluish gray. The camera essentially converts the infrared energy its sensors pick up into electronic images that display the surface temperature of the object being recorded. Getting more technical, the thermal imaging sensors Russia uses contain special optical systems. These focus the infrared energy captured onto a special chip, called a sensor array, that contain thousands of pixels arranged in a grid format. Each of those pixels reacts individually to the infrared energy focused onto it to produce an electronic signal. That signal is then converted from the pixel grid by the camera's sensor, which uses an internal and automatic mathematical calculation to convert the electronic signal into a color that can be shown on an electronic map. Temperature gradients are depicted using different colors, such as red for hot, with the camera's sensor developing a matrix of these colors to show the approximate temperatures of everything the camera catches. Many thermal imagers also incorporate a standard visible light camera. This allows the carrier to snap shots of standard images along with their thermal counterparts, allowing them to compare and ultimately zero in on the location of anything giving off a heat signature. What does this all mean on the battlefield? Well, imagine you're a Ukrainian soldier making your way through a forest en route to a Russian target. The trees around you are fairly cool, even during the summer, and your own exertions have raised your body temperature, along with the temperature of your clothes and equipment. If a Russian drone points its thermal imaging camera in your direction, it's going to see you as a moving blob of red and yellow against a blue-gray background of trees. Now the drone knows exactly where you are, and it can beeline toward your position. When it arrives, you're ambushed and the drone takes you out. Your mission is unsuccessful. The big problem for Ukraine is that Russia's use of thermal cameras has changed tremendously during Putin's war. When speaking to ABC News, Boryak explains how Russia has adapted to Ukraine's tactics. "It's drastically changed," he told the ABC reporter. "At the start of the war, the thermal imagers were mostly on tanks and special vehicles and aircraft, so it was not that big of a problem." Things got more challenging for Ukraine as Russia ramped up its usage of drones. "Of course there were drones," Boryak says about the early stages of the conflict, "but it was not something usual, not regular. Now, it is regular. Every month there are more and more and more drones." Boryak points out that Ukraine has more drones than Russia, along with more thermal sensors of its own, but they are raising their numbers too, he adds. And he's not wrong. The Ukraine war has served as a showcase for the utility of drones on both sides of the conflict. For Ukraine, drones have been useful for everything from basic reconnaissance to full-blown assaults on Russia's energy infrastructure and oil refineries. Putin, ever the follower in terms of tactics, realized how effective drones can be, and he's now using them to hunt down Ukraine's soldiers and bombard their cities with kamikaze drone strikes. He's not going to slow down anytime soon. According to Reuters, Russia intends to ramp up its drone production by 10 times to counteract Ukraine's use of these unmanned vehicles. In total, about 140,000 unmanned aerial vehicles of various types were delivered to the armed forces in 2023, Putin says when speaking about Russia's past drone production. This year, which was 2024, the production of drones is planned to increase significantly. Well, to be precise, by almost 10 times. If Putin's figures are accurate, that means that Russia produced around 1.4 million drones in 2024. Of course, not all of those drones would have thermal imaging cameras. Most would likely be kamikaze drones Russia could use to batter Ukrainian cities, along with its missiles and glide bombs. But that's not the only use that Russia has for its drones, as Boryak points out. And if evidence of twisted Russian training activities from the end of 2024 is anything to go by, Putin intends to use more drones than ever to hunt Ukraine's soldiers down in the field. What are these twisted training exercises? Well, Russia is using Ukrainian civilians as target practice for its drones. Both the BBC and Al Jazeera have reported on this phenomenon. The BBC says that such attacks have become commonplace in the besieged city of Kherson. It examined several videos purporting to show drone strikes on civilians, six of which it ran through its BBC Verify fact-checking platform. Each video seems to show the same thing: camera footage shot by a drone as a remote operator controls the unmanned vehicle. The drone will track a civilian or driver who appear to be wearing civilian clothing. When the drone draws near, it drops a grenade with the intention of killing or injuring the operator's target. You feel like you're constantly being hunted, like someone is always looking at you, and can drop explosives at any moment. It's the worst thing, says a Ukrainian aid worker named Kristina Sinaya, who works just 0.6 miles away from the contested Dnipro River. Al Jazeera's report is no less disturbing. It says the summer of 2024 saw Russia adopt a new drone tactic in which it used dozens of unmanned aerial vehicles to follow cars in cities where Ukrainians still live. Those drones hone in on their targets in what the outlet calls a video game-like chase before dropping grenades. The last 2 months of 2024 saw 16 people die and 144 injured by these attacks. Those drone strikes have a dual purpose. They sow seeds of terror among those brave enough to still live in the Ukrainian cities being targeted by Putin's invading forces. But they also serve as a terrible form of training, according to Kherson's deputy mayor Anton Yefanov. Russians in Kherson do not simply terrorize the population, they train on civilians. They practice in Kherson and then get transferred to Donetsk, where combat is more difficult due to close contact. We intercept many videos showing Russian soldiers hunting for people, says Yefanov. That brings us back to Ukraine's invisibility cloak. Russia's twisted training on Ukrainian civilians allows its troops to build familiarity with the drones they're using. When in the field, that familiarity manifests in Russian soldiers having a better understanding of how to use their drones to hunt down Ukraine's soldiers. So the new thermal invisibility cloak is designed to make that task much harder for the terrible Russian soldiers who commit war crimes against Ukraine's citizens, just to get better at killing Ukraine's soldiers on the front lines. The question now is, what types of soldiers does Ukraine intend to protect against thermal imaging cameras? Right now, the answer seems to be snipers and special forces soldiers. Fedorov touched on this when raving about the cloak's capabilities, with invisibility being perfect for snipers who often spend hours staying still in a single position until they get a clear shot of their target. The cloaks will also be useful for any other teams that are required to sneak behind the front lines, to conduct operations and carry out reconnaissance on Russia's forces. Sabotage and sapper teams will also find the cloaks useful, as will regular Ukrainian soldiers standing guard at observation posts or conducting slow-moving patrols at Ukraine's military sites. This limited utility reveals something else about Ukraine's invisibility cloaks. They're not perfect. Boryak is transparent about how the cloaks aren't suited to all military applications yet. The cloak's masking properties are preserved indefinitely as long as the person in the cloak moves very slowly, so that the human body does not additionally release excess heat. For example, when moving quickly over terrain, says the cloak's co-creator. That need to move slowly unfortunately means the cloaks aren't especially suitable for general infantry use and won't shield Ukrainian soldiers in the midst of nighttime raids against Russian positions. The cloak is designed for the slow positioning of a person in the place of dislocation and cannot be used during rapid movement, Boryak adds, before noting that the ventilation shaft that keeps the wearer cool could also be giveaways to Russia's thermal imaging technology if excess body heat is produced, such as what happens when running. Those conditions for the cloak may limit its utility, but they also make it perfect for the slow-moving snipers and special forces groups that are already putting it to good use in the field. The only further limitation Ukraine faces is one that has affected it throughout Putin's invasion: volume. When asked if Ukraine has enough of these cloaks by ABC, Boryak is frank about the situation. "Of course not," he tells the reporter. "There will never be enough of anything in the war, in the army." He then explains that it takes an enormous amount of work to produce just one of these invisibility cloaks. They are very, very hard to produce. One man can produce one cloak in 2 days if they work full workdays, he says, before revealing that there may be as few as 40 of the cloaks on the battlefield. Does that mean that the invisibility cloaks can't be the game changer Ukraine would want them to be? No. According to Newsweek, Boryak's team has a production capacity of 150 units per month if it's able to gain funding from either the Brave One project or Ukraine's many Western allies. He also says that his team could increase production if needed. the presented sample is ready for mass production and wide application in the area with the presence of natural vegetation when a person is in any position, standing, sitting, or lying down. In other words, Ukraine's invisibility cloak is ready to go. It just needs the requisite financial and manpower pushes to bring up production levels. Boryak's team is also still working on the cloak. His future plans include improving our product so that it can be used for fast movement in open terrain. Research is being conducted in this direction in cooperation with other scientists, he says. That research includes testing of different materials, which Boryak hopes will expand the cloak's masking properties. So it may not be long before we see more of these clever cloaks on the battlefield. And it gets worse for Putin. Boryak's team isn't the only one working hard to make Ukraine's soldiers invisible. In the wake of Boryak's innovation, Ukraine's Ministry of Defense approved testing on more anti-thermal cloaks, with 5 entering this examination phase early in 2024. We need to create a material that absorbs infrared radiation and has low thermal conductivity. Our goal is to camouflage military personnel and equipment from the enemy as reliably as possible, claimed Ukraine's former Deputy Minister of Defense Vitaly Povilenko. Ukrainian World Congress also points out that Ukraine now has access to samples of similar thermal camouflaging technology from its NATO partners, including Saab's Barracuda tech and samples of armored vehicles from Sweden that can evade thermal imaging. Boryak's cloak makes slow-moving Ukrainian forces invisible to Russia's thermal sensors. These additional technologies may help Ukraine develop thermal camouflage that's suitable for the entire Ukrainian military. There is one small wrinkle in this plan. Just as he did with Ukraine's use of drones, Putin is keen to copy the technology Ukraine is using to make its soldiers invisible. Russia's version is akin to a cocoon that a soldier places over their body so they can sprawl into position. It's cumbersome and nowhere near as versatile as the Ukrainian cloak. However, it also serves as a reminder that Russia will always try to copy any innovations it sees on the battlefield. Ukraine's job, along with NATO's, is to always ensure that its technology is better and more effective than the haphazard copies that Russia creates. So what do you think about Ukraine's invisibility cloaks? Do you think Boryak, with the help of Brave One, will be able to move into mass production? Could these cloaks be game changers in the Ukraine war, now that Putin is increasingly relying on drones? Let us know your thoughts in the comments, and thank you for watching the video. Now go and check out how Ukraine's paper planes are destroying Russia's military, or click this other video instead.